I am Dave, and welcome to my latest Reclaiming My Youth Outdoors Adventure video. This time's adventure was a bikepacking trip where I got my bike out, put on my backpack, got it packed up with all the stuff I needed to go camping, and I biked out to go camping. My trip consisted of starting in Waterloo Recreation Area and going to the Pinckeny Recreation Area. It followed mostly roads but some trails, and round trip that it was about 40 miles. Through this video, I actually ran into a number of technical difficulties. That is why you are getting this intro in front of my computer instead of where I started my trip. Some of my technical difficulties where I had gotten a new camera and wasn't 100% familiar with it, and didn't realize for the intro that the camera was muted. So you got about, I'd say, a minute and a half of me speaking with no sound. That, and when it was attached to my bike, some of the roads and trails I was on were a little bit on the bumpy side, so it didn't actually do anything to help really fix that too much, so some of that video is unusable. Another problem is when my camera started to die, I went to the phone to do things like me actually talking to the viewers. Unfortunately, I didn't realize I had it on time lapse, so instead of getting a lot of video of me talking about what I was doing and what's going on, you get about 5 seconds of me flapping my lips around really, really quick. With that, let's move on then. As you can see in my original intro video, I had good picture quality but no sound, which is unfortunate because it would have come out really good. This video shows that my new camera looks like on a bumpy road. Again, unfortunate. There are some beautiful footage of groves of trees with changing leaves, which I find most people enjoy. I've always preferred evergreens because I like green trees and associate change of leaf color with the barren trees of winter. I plan to replace some of this footage with still shots taken from the videos. As I said earlier, I started shooting self videos with my phone after my camera initially died. After charging it overnight, I continued recording with my camera for all self shots. Because of not paying attention, I ended up recording everything on my camera in time lapse. Here is my route to camp. In the next scene, you'll notice it is significantly different than my return trip, and I explain why later in the video. As you can see, I covered just over 25 and a half miles. My return trip was shorter and more direct. I even traveled through the small town of Chelsea. With that said, let's get to the reason why you are watching this video. Well, I finally hit Pinckeny Recreation Area, and now I'm about to hit the actual mountain biking trail. So no more roads, no more gravel, no more pavement, just straight mountain biking trails from this point on. According to my GPS, I should probably hit the headquarters in about 30 minutes where I will get my permit to be able to camp. I've already reserved it, but you have to go and pick it up before you start to camp. I was told if I do manage to get there after they've already closed, I can pick it up in the morning after I've camped, but I should be able to make it. I'll definitely be making it there before they close. With that, I'm gonna stop now and take a small break, eat a little snack, and then we'll get back to the trail. It didn't take long after getting on the mountain biking trail to realize that either one, I was not built for mountain biking, or two, being as weighed down as I was with my backpack and the like was making it very difficult, to say the least. Another thing I had going against me was that the trails were one way for bikes and another way for hikers. My plans had me going the wrong way down the trails, and taking the correct way would have added miles more to the mountain bike trail. Because of this, I rerouted my trip home to avoid the mountain biking trails. Well, I made it here to the registration building. I've actually already gone to camp, dropped off my pack. It's been quite the day, so I figured have a nice light trip to get registered, and I'm gonna do that and then head back to camp. So I'll talk to you when I get there. Well, this is my camp. As you can see in the background, I got my tent set all up. It's a actually pretty nice camp spot. I was hoping to build a fire, but it doesn't look like I'm going to be able to. They don't apparently sell wood at the headquarters, and I've looked around a little bit and the pickings are pretty slim, so it looks like I'll be making my food again on a stove. So much for testing out my ability to light a fire with flint and steel. And it also looks like that the mosquitoes are around, so I'm probably going to be putting on some mosquito lotion to keep them away. But as you can see, looking around, sun pretty nice. Got the leaves changing. There's actually back that way a lake. I won't be doing anything with that. Not really my fave. But look at that, changing leaf color. I personally actually prefer green to even the changing colors, but hey, each their own. That's why I prefer conifer evergreen forests, because they're always green. With that said, I am going to actually maybe do a little more looking around, possibly be able to find some wood so that I can have a fire. Otherwise, I will probably just make dinner using my stove. As you can see from behind me, I did get the fire going. I managed to find some wood. I did light it with flint and steel. But I kind of cheated. I brought cotton balls just in case. I couldn't find any decent tinder, which I really wasn't much of what I did find. Ended up being slightly damp, so it really wasn't lighting. And I know I can light a cotton ball with a very few strokes of a flint and steel. So I did manage to get that done. So once this fire burns down a bit, I will use the coals to start making dinner, and I will see you then. Well, dinner time's here. What I have for tonight is a chicken burrito. Right here, I have strips of chicken with butter, garlic, pepper, and here I have a mix of veggies, which is made up of lettuce, onions, jalapenos, salsa, and cheese. These have all been vacuum sealed, so they should still be good, and I literally just pulled them out of the refrigerator this morning, so they should not have gone bad in that period of time. And then, of course, I have the flour tortilla right there. It should be pretty good. I have the pan here. Put the chicken in the pan. Once it's all done, I'll cut open the cheese and such. Put that all with the chicken into the flour tortilla. I'll show you when it's done. From this point on, I began using my phone in time-lapse to record myself. Therefore, you will see no more dialogue with me until the wrap-up, so enjoy the rest of the footage. Okay, with my trip complete, let me give you my final thoughts. To start, for gear, again, my backpack needs to be replaced. It's very uncomfortable, but I imagine that if it carried less, it would probably be okay. Next, on the way to camp, I was expecting to use my bike's rear wheel shelf to carry firewood. That didn't happen. They didn't sell firewood, so I could have made use of that for other things, such as, you know, carrying my tent. I did do that on the trip back, and it relaxed quite a bit of the weight from my pack. My Gold Flip 36 power bank was a godsend. I was able to charge my phone, my Fitbit watch, and my camera overnight, and it used up very little of the power reserve. To put things in perspective, my phone, which is an LG Style 5, had less than half its power, which my Fitbit Iconic was almost dead. And as I mentioned earlier, my newer G1 action camera had died. The item right after my backpack to be replaced is probably going to be my sleeping bag. Don't get me wrong, it keeps you plenty warm, but it also takes up a ton of space in the bag. And last but not least, my tent. It was outstanding. I could not have asked for more, with one exception. While it checks all the necessary boxes, such as keeping the weather out as well as insects, it has two good size vestibules, it lacks any inside pockets that could be used for storing small items such as your phone or a small flashlight. But I think this is something I could probably live without, however. Well, with all my equipment that I used will be listed in the description below. Now for my trip, I had a good time, but I have to admit, biking with all that weight is exhausting. I started off strong, but up and down hills, especially on mountain biking trails, can wear you down quickly. The food I made was excellent this trip for both dinner and the cream of wheat that I had for breakfast the next morning. I did find sleeping directly on the ground not as easy as it once had. Therefore, I see a sleeping pad sometime in my near future. Bikepacking for me was an entirely new experience, and while I did enjoy it, I think I still prefer backpacking more. This is not to say I won't try doing it again, but for now I think I'll focus mostly on backpacking. And with all that said, well, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you in the next one.